Welcome back. This time I'm introducing a new segment for the channel I'm going to call Trailer Rant. And frankly, this is a segment I hope I don't have to use too often because this is where I complain about trailers that spoil major plot points of the movies they're trying to advertise. In this case, I'm talking about Criminal. Now, if you saw my review for that movie, I enjoyed it, but I did mention in there that the trailer did give away some major plot points going into the third act of the film. And I didn't want to get into too much detail in that video because I didn't want to spoil the film just like the trailers did. So if you haven't seen Criminal, I would stop now because this video is going to have spoilers for that film up until all the way through until the last scene. If you haven't seen it, go see my review and see if it is a movie that you might want to go see. With that warning out of the way, let's jump into this. Now, I love trailers. I'll say that up front. I've always loved trailers. I've always loved the art of making a good trailer. There are some wonderful trailers out there. There's some trailers that are downright beautiful. The trailer for Cloud Atlas, that's just honestly one of my favorite trailers of all time. And then there's also trailers that are better than the movies that they were advertising. One of my favorite trailers of all time is one of the original trailers for Pearl Harbor. You can actually find it online, but it does not have the original music track that trailer had in theaters. They've used some of the score from The Thin Red Line, if I'm not mistaken, and they actually didn't have the proper rights to do that. So when they released it online, they changed the music, and it never had quite the same feel because the trailer was cut to work with that original track. And then you have films like the Transformers movies, always had great trailers. The movies pretty much sucked. And then you have trailers that just spoil the crap out of movies. Two prime examples, I'm not going to get them into any detail because I want to talk about Criminal in this one, but I may go back later and do other ones, do other videos for these movies, but the hall of shame for me for trailers that spoil movies are number one, Castaway, number two, Prometheus. The Batman v Superman trailer that showed who was going to arrive in the final act of that film would probably get on there, but Castaway, Prometheus, by far, 1 and 2 for most spoiler-filled trailers. So for Criminal, this is a film I enjoyed. Wasn't a perfect film, but it was an enjoyable R-rated bloody action movie. Again, you can watch my video review on that if you want to see more of my opinions on it. But I kind of gave it a pass for some elements that just could have been a bit predictable, and that was because I knew they were coming because of the trailer. Now, this is a trailer that I probably saw in theaters 4 to 5 times. I'm at the theater every week to watch movies, so a lot of times I will see the same trailer over and over again. And I do my best not to overanalyze trailers for fear of spoilers. But this is one I really wasn't that terribly worried about. And out of context, you don't really know that you're being spoiled. And this comes in, there's two major plot points that the trailer gives away way, way too early. One, and this is something if you watch the trailer, you realize right away that this is a plot point. I just didn't realize it was going to arrive in the movie so late. I'm assuming at this point you have seen the movie, but the main character, Jericho, played by Kevin Costner, is this criminal who has had these memories implanted in his brain that belonged to this CIA agent played by Ryan Reynolds. And over the course of the movie, these memories and these emotions are changing him. And he's starting to feel these emotions that he's never felt for, specifically for Ryan Reynolds' wife and daughter. And there's a moment in the trailer.
Last chance, or they die.
There's too many lives at stake. They don't matter.
So it's very obvious from what you're seeing and what you're hearing that the family has been kidnapped. Which, again, wouldn't be that huge a deal, except they don't get kidnapped until... I can't do a perfect estimate on the time here without taking a stopwatch and going to see the movie again because it just came out. But it's in the final act. I mean, having watched the trailer, I honestly thought they were going to get kidnapped maybe halfway through the movie, maybe a little bit even earlier, and that was going to pace it off. But as I was watching the movie, I'm like, okay, he's getting closer to the family. They're having all these moments, and I'm like, okay, I know where this is leading. I know this is leading to them getting kidnapped. Now, obviously, a movie like this, when you have him getting closer to the family, you can pretty much assume that sooner or later they're going to get kidnapped by the bad guys so he can have these emotional moments. But there's some tension there on whether that's where they're going to go with it or not. Having seen the trailer, I knew exactly where it was going. And it just, it dragged, made the second act really drag because I knew where they were going. Obviously there's moments in films where it's just set up. Well, this was obvious setup because I knew where it was going. I mean, it's like, you know, that's the first big spoiler that just, like, it drove me nuts. Cause I kept waiting for them to get kidnapped. And they didn't get kidnapped until, like, maybe the last 20, 25 minutes of the movie. It's just like, oh, why? That's not even the worst one. The worst one, by far. And it seems like a throwaway scene in the trailer. It's almost like, on one hand, it's like we just needed something to fill in another 3 seconds of this trailer. And the other thing is we need an explosion. And there's literally, if I remember correctly, there's 3 explosions in this movie. One of them, having, again, out of context, watching the trailer, I'm like, oh, okay, that's probably something that happens early on in the film. And that is the private jet blowing up. And again, going into it, you don't know that you've just been spoiled. You're following Jericho, he's trying to get the family back, he tracks them to this airport, and you got the main bad guy, and you got all his thugs, and you got the family. And what's there? The jet. And just before this scene, when Jericho tracks down the hacker, he has him make a change to the program. And they do a good job of not telling you exactly what it reprogrammed. And with Jericho being the character he is, you really don't know where he's going. His morality is definitely chaotic neutral at this point. So you don't know. You get to the airport, you see the plane, and my first thought was, plane, reprogrammed software, he's going to get him to shoot the plane down. Guess what happens 10 minutes later?
This world.
And I'm like, really? Why would you show that? Oh, it's annoying. It's a 3-second clip. And again, out of context, you don't know you've just had the ending spoiled for you. As soon as you see the plane, if you have any memory of this trailer, it's one of the more memorable moments in the trailer. And it's like, because it's a pretty cool scene of this plane blowing up. And it's like, crap, I know exactly where this is going. And then, as if that wasn't bad enough, and this is actually something I didn't remember, so it wasn't spoiled for me. The last scene of the movie is Jericho back on the beach, and it's bookending what you saw at the beginning, which is even worse. Because if I had remembered this, I knew exactly how the movie was going to end. The first scene of the movie is Jericho on the beach, and he says some things, you don't know why he's at the beach. And then as the movie goes on, you know, he and the wife have this conversation about the beach. So you know it's going to somehow, you know, because of the way the movie was put together, that he's going to get back to that beach. But in the trailer, they show him on the beach, which, you know, technically could be the first, but it shows the daughter running up to him.
But they were wrong.
Which is literally in the last 2 minutes of this movie. Had I remembered that, and I don't even know why I didn't, but if I had remembered that, as soon as I saw that first scene of him on the beach, I knew how this last scene was going to play out. And I'm just thankful I managed to forget that scene, because yeah, so we have the main plot point, the main action plot point, the destruction death of the main character, plus the last scene and how it's going to resolve all spoiled in this trailer. And that is why I'm ranting about it. Obviously, pretty much every trailer, you know, there's a good trailers don't, but a lot of trailers give away plot points here or there. This is just one where it was like so much of the last act of this movie got ruined by the trailer. I still enjoyed it, but it's not the experience that the filmmakers wanted me to have going into this movie. So the trailer robbed me of that. And again, that's why I'm ranting. So, if you've seen Criminal and you saw this trailer and you had a similar reaction to me as you were watching it, please let me know. I want to know if I'm an outlier on this. Also, without spoiling the specific points, in case I haven't actually had a chance to see that movie, let me know below what trailers that you think are the worst at spoiling the movies they're advertising. Let me know what you thought about it. Like I said, this is a little bit different than what I usually do. And if you enjoy it, I'll see what else I can do that's similar. But until then, I'll see you at the movies. Hopefully those that aren't spoiled by trailers.